Over the last 20 years, NASCAR has seen a nearly immeasurable amount of change. This plunged the fan base into a seemingly endless war of old school mentalities versus modern updates. The fact of the matter is that while the fan base has slightly moved in terms of openness to change, when you look at the grand scheme of things, it's still apparent that the change needle is still quite close to where it was back in 2004. So with so many on either side, it's still a valid question to ask if the sanctioning body should focus more on preserving long-standing tradition or just flying past it to keep up with the times. It's an interesting question to ponder, and I can definitely say that there is no definitive way to answer it. There has to be a natural balance point somewhere between old school and new school, and I think it's always shifting. It always needs to be taken on in a case-by-case basis as well. Starting off, you have to look at where they race. This is where an old-school approach is desperately needed. There is constant talk nowadays of aero packages. Going to old-school tracks with more short tracks and such would be an easier way to deal with these package problems rather than going to more aero-dependent tracks. NASCAR understands this fully. Currently, they're in intense negotiations with the city of Nashville to bring back the fairgrounds, and now, with a heavy push from the fans, there are rumblings of a resurrection of the relic of the past called North Wilkesboro. On the TV front, NBC Sports is now highlighting small short tracks for NASCAR coverage across America. It's going to take some time to get the short track movement really rolling again, but it is clear that there is at least some executive and network wins that are blowing in the sails compared to recently. So on the track front, generally old school is the way to go. The only exception really being the fast-growing road course movement. Again, this can be seen in recent changes with the addition of more road courses, the Charlotte Roval being the powder keg for this movement, leading to the Indy road course in the Xfinity Series and the Daytona road course in the Clash. So with the overall take on this topic, it leans traditional, but needs some modern adaptations. Now, you need to look at the cars that race on these tracks. This is an area where a lot of young fans say that absolutely there needs to be change and updates. I understand this. Keeping everything the same is a fast way to stagnate, but I also am of the mindset that changing for the sake of changing is immeasurably stupid. The next gen car looks to be making wholesale changes. Pretty much all of the changes look to be meant to either reduce long-term costs or become more efficient overall. Now this is all taken from NASCAR itself because the sanctioning body has been quite secretive with the car. So only time will tell. The only thing that we've seen definitively talked about is the number placement and a single lug wheel. And this shows two common points. The single lug wheel is a safety precaution with the 18-inch aluminum wheels, which are meant to be more stock. And the number placements show why change seemingly for change, or only at executive bottom lines, is not a good strategy. Keep what needs to be kept, and modernize what is essential to modernize. It's the obvious take here. The next front overall is traditions. NASCAR, more than any other sports league, banks on traditions. And the branch off from tradition is one of the most egregious sins that they have had against the fans over the last 30 years. The losses of North Wilkesboro, Rockingham, and one of the Darlington races immediately showed the Brian France era's forward and beginning trends. The championship, which had been, like any other traditional racing series, a full season championship, now changes continuously. The cars change from having relative brand identity to none to identifiable again. Races like the Southern 500, Brickyard 400, and Firecracker 400 have all been moved all over the schedule at different points. The Southern 500 and Firecracker 400 having a real historical significance with their original dates. Segmented stage racing, green-white checkers, double-file restarts, and more have all been adding to this as well, getting further and further away from what NASCAR had been for so long. So what should NASCAR go with? Again, I think it's a mixed bag. Races like the Southern 500 and the Firecracker 400 need to stay on their dates. Darlington on Labor Day weekend, Daytona on the 4th of July weekend. Rules like championships, stages, and race procedures become a person-by-person preference, in my opinion. For me, I'd get rid of stages, get rid of the green-white checkers and double-file restarts, but again, I'm a traditional fan, so take this how you will. So with the rules and traditions, NASCAR should stay traditional, in my opinion. Lastly, when looking at traditionalism versus modernism, the biggest question is always on the front of the fans. NASCAR has had a huge problem since 2005 gaining new fans. I'm not going to go through this again, though. I can do it on another video, and videos or articles about NASCAR's fall on the internet are a dime a dozen, so if you want to hear about it, look those up. What's important to know is that this fall has led to an unhealthy cycle that NASCAR has still yet to escape from, trying to change themselves to win over a goal fan. For anybody who's been awkward and acted differently to impress a crush in high school, you can attest to the fact of the fruitless nature of this approach. Here's the main problem. NASCAR needs new fans to survive. What NASCAR's approach should have been and should be is to show new fans why its traditions and why it in and among itself is so badass. And it is. It is a badass sport. The mistake that NASCAR has made was trying too much to fit in to whatever modern day is or was, not realizing that this immediately dated each season that they did these things with and really took away from the long-term health of the sport. I don't like doing this, but since so many fans do it, I'll bite on this. Look at other major sports leagues in America that NASCAR tries to emulate and compete with. The NFL, the MLB, and the NBA. A takeaway of the last 20 or so years from these leagues and the biggest difference of these old games really is just the quality of footage and more streamlined uniforms nowadays. These leagues generally don't make wholesale changes to how the fundamental game is played. The one that has looked into it, the MLB, is seeing a horribly nasty backlash from their long-term fans. Overall, what NASCAR needs is to be comfortable in its own skin. NASCAR isn't the NFL or the NBA or the MLB. It also is not March Madness. It is NASCAR racing. You can change little things and modernize the cars, but changing to fit fans who are adjacent to you, sometimes purposefully, is a quick way to minimize your audience. NASCAR racing is 40 of the most brave people in America pushing themselves and their machines to the limit, inches apart, sliding around, all at 200 miles an hour. When people stop to give it a chance, they usually, at the very least, respect it. Where modernization is always needed is in marketing and internet presence at this point. And this is where NASCAR in the post-Brian France era has excelled, vaulting itself from a 2006 style culture to the modern day in nearly a year and a half. But with all of this said, I think that I should just leave it here now to you. Where do you think NASCAR should balance itself on modernization versus traditionalism? Let me know down in the comments below. And while you're at it, leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more great NASCAR content. And until next time, have a good one.